NFL Week 11. I'm going to need a whole lot of teams to show me something. The Sports Opinion Log here on LexAnderson World. And so if you're down with all things NFL, AFC, NFC, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to stay notified for any and all upcoming future videos. Thursday Night Football, the Steelers fell to the Bengals 21-7. NFL Week 11 starting with the 1 o'clock games. The 6-3 Texans on the road taking on the 7-2 Ravens. Deshaun Watson, the Michael Jordan of the NFL. Someone tell Max Kellerman, stop stealing my fucking soundbites. You heard it here first. We're going to go with the Ravens, though. The Ravens lead the series 7-2 and have won 2 out of the last 3. Make it 3 out of the last 4. The 2-7 Falcons on the road taking on the 5-4 Panthers. Upset game of the week. We're going to go with the Falcons on this one. And in case you're going to say, Lex Anderson, why? You hate Matt Ryan. Yes, I do. You hate the Atlanta Falcons franchise. Yes, I do. However, the Falcons lead the series 30-18. They've won the last 3 games. Matt Ryan owns the Panthers 14-8, 6-1 over his last 7 starts, in which he's averaged 318 yards to go with 15 touchdowns and only 3 interceptions. We're celebrating the NFL's 100th anniversary in 2002. The Falcons shut out the Panthers twice, 30-0 in Week 7, 41-0 in Week 12. Atlanta is one of only 7 teams to shut out one team twice in the regular season. The 5-4 Cowboys taking on the Lions in Detroit. The Lions 3-5-1. Of course, no Matthew Stafford should be no problem. Look for the Cowboys to win. They lead the series 14-11. They've won the last 2. And Dak Prescott, 5 touchdowns, 0 INTs for a rating of 135.7 in 2 career games versus the Lions. And never forget, on October 27th, 2013, wide receiver Calvin Johnson, 14 catches, 329 receiving yards, second most receiving yards in a single game in NFL history for a Lions 31-30 win over the Cowboys. Okay, Jaguars 4-5 on the road at the Colts 5-4. The return of Nick Foles, the return of Jacoby Brissett, an upset game of the week. I'm going with the Jaguars. The Colts lead the series 23-13. However, the Jaguars have won 3 out of the last 4 and have not allowed a point in the last 3 halves against Indy. And Adam Vinatieri, folks, he fucking sucks. He's mixed 6 extra points and 5 field goals on the season. Adam Vinatieri, look for him to be the reason why the prophet will decree that the Jaguars will win against the Indianapolis Colts. Bills 6-3 at Miami, taking on the Dolphins 2-7. We're going to go with the Bills. Even though the Dolphins lead the series 60 wins, 46 losses with 1 tie, the Bills, however, have won the last 2. The Broncos 3-6, heading over to Minnesota, taking on the 7-3 Vikings. Series is tied 7 games apiece. Denver has won the last 3. But we're going to go with the Vikings to secure the win. Speaking of securing the win, Saints 7-2 on the road in Tampa Bay, taking on the Buccaneers, who are 3-6. Saints lead the series 34-21 and have won the last 2. Will New Orleans, will the Saints, will Drew Brees do right by the prophet? Woo! The Jets 2-7 in Washington, taking on the Redskins 1-8. Macaroni 7, you're my boy. Don't let me down. I'm going with it. Brother K, DJ Porscut, Raysky, all the Jet fans. I'm going to pick the Jets. However, the Redskins lead the series 9-3. The Jets have won the last 2. And on a historic note, on November 5th, 1972, Washington quarterback Billy Kilmer threw touchdown passes of 45, 70, and 89 yards in a 35-17 win over the Jets. Again, we're celebrating the NFL 100th anniversary with special footnotes in history. Upset game of the week, the 3-6-1 Cardinals at the 8-1 Niners. I'm going to go with the Cardinals because even though the Niners lead the series 30-26, the Cardinals have won 8 out of the last 9 games. Kittle is probably not going to play. Emmanuel Sanders, rib cartilage issues, That's tough. But they will fall back down to earth. They will lose this game. Side note on history, November 8th, 1986, Hall of Famers Joe Montana and Jerry Rice connected on three touchdown passes of 40-plus yards in the Niners' 43-17 victory over the Cardinals. 81 Patriots heading into Philly, taking on the 5-4 Eagles, who lead the series 7-5. The Patriots have won three out of the last four. Let's not talk about any Super Bowl bullshit rematch, because Wentz was not the starter. It was Nick Foles. I don't believe in Carson Wentz to come through. The Patriots' defense in the air is no joke. I look to see maybe 2 to 3 interceptions of Carson Wentz by the Patriots in this one. And, of course, a footnote in history, Super Bowl 52, Nick Foles became the first player in league history to throw a touchdown pass and catch a touchdown pass in a Super Bowl. Bengals 0-9 at the Raiders 5-4. Look for the Raiders to win this one. They lead the series 18-11. The Bengals have won the last three, but the Bengals are 0-9. They're still looking for their first win. You could see, you could smell, you could feel the desperation, like the single lonely hoes on Twitter who talk about how happy they are being single. But we know you're not. You're miserable. You're lonely. You're single. It's the holiday season. Love is not approaching you. You won't have any in your life. You won't have any in your heart. And the Bengals sure as fuck will not be picking up their first one of the season over the Raiders. Okay, Sunday Night Football, the 4-5 Bears at the 5-4 Rams with their disappointing season. I've talked about it already. Super Bowl fallout. It's unfolding before our very eyes. Sean McVay, the much-heralded genius coach, as they like to label white men. Whatever. Jared Goff, like I told you, the one-trick pony. Can't move the offense on his fucking own to save his fucking life. We're going to go with the Rams anyway because the Bears' offense is just that goddamn bad. Footnote in history, the Bears do lead the series, though, 53-35 with three ties and have won the last two. In 1985, the Chicago Bears beat the Rams 24-0 in the NFC Championship game to advance to the Super Bowl. But before they got there, they had also shut out the Giants. And the 1985 Chicago Bears are the only team in NFL history to have back-to-back shutouts in the postseason. So just keep that in mind whenever you're talking to your friends about who's got a great defense. Clearly, it was once the Bears, long time ago, folks, 1985. Monday Night Football, the 6-4 Chiefs at the LA Chargers, who are 4-6. Gotta love those inverted numbers. We're gonna go with the Chiefs on this one. They lead the series 61-55 with one tie. The Chiefs have won 9 out of the last 10. Patrick Mahomes, 6 touchdowns, 0 INTs for a quarterback rating of 122.2 in two career games. However, Phillip Rivers has thrown for 6,870 career passing yards, the most versus any team of the league. It will be for naught because it will be the Chiefs coming out on top. And speaking of coming out on top, that's the end of this video. Thank you very much for tuning in. Special shout out to my IGTV family. Greetings and salutations to all of you. Week 11, let's get it going. Lex Anderson, Sports Opinion Log, representing the Steel City. Despite the horrifying loss and altercation that followed afterwards, which again you can find by checking out my next video, Lex Anderson, signing out.